Now let's move on to the best twist. Right, best twist. Best twist is a twist in the film that was good. Right, okay then. Let's start off with Ender's Game. The game is real. This caught me off guard completely. I mean, at the end, we got this whole epic scene in which Ender's going, fire, 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 and he's throwing all these spaceships at each other. And he kills, like, tons of folk. Like, he just leaves them there because he thinks it's a simulator. He lets all those folk die. There's like, probably a million in each ship. Maybe not that much, but there's tons, and they all just get destroyed. And he pretty much nukes the planet, kind of. It's not really a nuke, but he blows the planet up. And then it turns out it's real. And the way that it makes it even better, this twist, and how, like, shocking it is just before the battle starts. The aliens aren't actually attacking. They're just sitting there. They're waiting. So obviously that meant that they didn't actually want to attack. Yet Ender just fires everything in because he thinks it's a game, he thinks it's a simulator. And I got him, I love that twist. It caught me off guard. It was amazing. Oh gosh. Right, next one. The Game Master is a Rebel from Hunger Games Catching Fire. This was another one that caught me off guard, really. I kind of thought he was an villain, but the whole plan of what was actually happening, the revolution, everything really caught me off guard. I knew the revolution was happening, I didn't know exactly how it was going to end, because I kind of knew that Peter and Katniss would make it out. I was just like, but they're not going to do the exact same thing as they did in the first one, are they? And it's just that I don't think they would make the same mistake of having berries together with them. But instead, she just blows up the entire thing, and she gets saved by Philip Seymour Hoffman, who turns out to be a hero. Woohoo! Right, yeah, this is twisted, catch me off guard, I loved it. It really, really was a good twist. Right, let's move on to the final one. Loki's betrayal and his illusion from Thor of the Dark World. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead. I would have probably hated this film if Loki had been the villain again. As much as I love the character of Loki, having him the villain in Thor, the Avengers, and Thor 2 would have probably been way too much for me. Mind you, to be honest, I think he would have been a better villain than Christopher Eccleston. As much as I love the actor, what was he doing? It felt more like Star Trek, actually. Right, Mr. Spock. Yes, Thor. Mr. Spock, we need to find Loki. Okay, what are we going to do with this guy? I don't know. Okay, let's go. Yeah, we didn't actually know what was happening with Christopher Eccleston's character, and it was a bit unnecessary, the whole Star Trek thing there. but I was ready to pretty much just hate on the film, because when Loki betrayed Thor and cut off his hand, I was pretty much going, I was disappointed, because I was like, oh god, they've done it, why? I knew it was coming. And then next thing, they end up just working together. It turns out that Thor actually hasn't lost his arm. And I pretty much was ready to jump out of the seat in celebration. I loved that twist so much. They played on the fact that everybody knew that, or everyone thought that Loki was going to betray him, including the people in the film. It wasn't just the fans that went, oh, alright, Loki's going to betray him. No, it was everybody. Including the film, they're all like constantly firing swords at him, just like, you betray him, I'll kill you. It's just like, apparently there'll be a line. Okay. He's meant to be pushing away the sword there, he's not just going, dun, 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 dun. Right. But yeah, brilliant twist. However, there wasn't always good twists. Let's move on to the worst twists. Yes, these twists were bad. Let's go straight into the worst twists then. Starting with the Mandarin is a fake Iron Man 3. Okay, this twist caught me off guard. Doesn't mean it was a good one though. I hated this twist more because they completely ruined the character of the Mandarin. The Mandarin, I've already mentioned this in the Wasted Opportunity section, but he could have been amazing. He could have been an amazing villain. They had a brilliant actor playing him. They had Ben Kingsley. And what does he do? Well, they have a heroin and stuff like that. Oh, and not to mention he's probably sleeping with a bunch of prostitutes.
What?
Oh, yeah. It's like Batman walking in and Joker just sitting there with a bunch of weed. Hey, Batman.
Batman's in. You're the Joker.
It's like, yeah. It's all part of the plan. I wanted you to think that I was actually a psychopath, but I'm not. I'm actually very clever. And I'm going to sit here. I'm not actually going to fight you, don't worry. But, so you may want to run around, get the cops, I don't care. You can just imagine that. And that's pretty much what they've done with the Mandarin. I mean, why? It's not a big rant I'm going into, but it was dreadful, this twist. Let's move on to one that... It was a bit of a bad twist, I got to admit. And that is Turbo is the King from Wreck-It Ralph. Turbo was basically the villain or the random side backstory thing that just done halfway through the film for no reason. He's going Turbo! Who's Turbo? Turbo is the guy that happened to leave and is the only one and he hasn't been seen for ages. Let's think. Maybe it's someone here. Someone's bound to be Turbo. I mean, why else would they bring it up? Oh, and it's the King. Oh, I never thought that. Especially considering the King's the one that's making up all these lies and stuff like that about the little girl. Or the glitch. Oh, I don't know whether they were lies or not. I can't remember. But yeah, it was a bad twist. And finally, let's move on to... As much as I love this film, the twist in this. I mean, I don't know why J.J. Abrams thought this would be a brilliant twist. And that is... John Harrison is Khan. I mean, seriously, it just doesn't make any sense. They're running around and even Benedict Cumberbatch is like, yes, my name is John Harrison. It's not Khan. As much as everyone thinks it's Khan, it's not. And then everyone's like, when the trailer comes out, they're just like, it's Khan! And Benedict Cumberbatch is just like, shit. No, it's actually John Harrison. It's like, and then when they eventually reveal it, I can just imagine being in the Enterprise. I mean, I can just imagine this actually for the people who don't know who Khan is. Just Benedict Cumberbatch, she's going, my name is Khan. And everyone just sitting there is just like, okay, why'd you change your name? I don't get it. And then other people, like all the Star Trek fans and people who know who Khan is, are just basically going like this.
My name is Khan.
That just basically explains how bad this twist was. The delivery of the twist. Maybe, I don't know. I mean, it's not as if it would have made a big difference. If they'd found out it was Khan from the beginning, it would have been a different film. I think J.J. Abrams just wanted to make us smile when we realised it was Khan, but we knew it from the beginning. That's all I really need to say. So let's move, I don't know why I keep on biting my legs, but let's move on to the best fight scene, just to lighten up the mood a bit. Best fight scene is basically the best scene in which characters fight or there's like a fight. That's really the explanation I can give you for it. But let's move on to the best fight scene, or we already are on it, but let's start off with the final battle of Kick-Ass 2. More specifically, Hit Girl vs. Mother Russia. As much as the final battle is really good with Kick-Ass and the Motherfucker, yeah, okay, Hit Girl, Mother Russia. This is the main fight. As much as people wanted Kick-Ass to get revenge for his dad, yeah, we've got Hit Girl, Mother Russia fighting. We've got perhaps one of the best characters ever versing like this crazy, evil, cold-hearted killer. Plus, he's extremely strong. And then Hit Girl takes some stuff. It's a really good fight, actually, to watch. So, that's really all I can say. Let's move on now to the bathroom fight in World's End. This fight was, oh my god, this fight was brilliant. It was probably the first time in the Cornetto trilogy in which there was actually stunt coordination, like proper fight scenes and fight coordination and stuff like that. As much as the fights in the original, in the first two were really good, but these ones were really professional. It felt really professional compared to their ones. Kind of just threw them to the side. Oh god, I mean, when basically in the bathroom fight, they realise that the town is like taken over by robots. Wait, no. Robot means slave, and they are not slaves, they are free. Blanks! You're a blank! You're a blank! You're a blank! He's a blank! She's a blank! They're all blanks! I had to take that out for some reason. But yes, this scene was amazing. It was intense. I mean, I loved watching the characters. I mean, Simon Pegg just fighting everything in the bathroom, and especially when he first takes him out, just knocks off his head. He was just left smiling. Not really, I was left smiling. He was left like wondering what the hell was happening. But yeah, it was a really good fight scene. Next one, the bullet train fight from Wolverine. Okay, I will admit, when I first saw the trailer, I thought this film, well, not the film, but I thought this scene was probably going to be the worst in the film. It just didn't look that good. In fact, it actually looked quite bad with the whole CGI. The CGI didn't look very good in the fight, but this fight was brilliant. Basically, they're on a train, bullet train, and the train's like going bullet train speed, which is like really fast. And Wolverine's having to calculate, like, lifting his claws up and then flying, basically, and try and kill this other guy. And it's this whole fight in which they're pulling themselves forward. It's a really intense fight. It's very, very good. It's really... I was on the edge of my seat probably for this fight. That's how good it was. And that's pretty much it.